passe les heures, elle passe son cœur, à Paris comme ailleurs. Passe les jours, elle passe l'amour, le temps nous joue des tours.
Spirits, Lou. Was he thought he was in okay spirits?
Yes, he had three kids there. I mean, he was a wonderful father. I mean, he was happy because I mentioned to him, "Are you nervous about doing the tour?" He goes, "No." He says, "I can't wait to get on stage."
Now that, and that's in, you know, in contrast to what we've been hearing from other people.
Yeah, because a lot of people are negative.
For
I don't
sure.
know what happened the last month, but the time I was with Michael, I mean, he was determined. And he was a genuine guy. Plus, he was a prankster too.
Oh,
he was
really?
Always playing jokes.
Like what?
But sometimes he would call. One time he called, he said, "This is Omar." And I for 10 minutes, I thought this guy was stalking me. And I found out it was Michael. I said,
Omar,
"Michael, where did you get your butt in the gym?" I said, "I'm going to whip your butt this time." I said, "You son of a..." But he was always playing jokes on me, you know, like calling me on the phone. But he was a regular a kid, a great
you say,
guy.
Omar, you sound an awful lot like Michael Jackson with that voice.
He has such a distinctive voice. He could do other voices.
Yeah. Yeah, sometimes he disguised himself, like recently, like he could not come to my facility because people would follow him. And I heard a couple of stories how he put a mannequin himself in the ambulance, and he'd be driving with the ambulance, you know, playing, stealing away the paparazzi.
That's funny.
Michael was a fun, he's fun.
Now look,
and I heard a couple of stories how he put a mannequin himself in the ambulance, and he'd be driving with the ambulance, you know, playing, stealing away the paparazzi.
That's funny.
Michael was a fun, he's fun.
Now look,
and I heard a couple of stories how he put a mannequin himself in the ambulance, and he'd be driving with the ambulance, you know, playing, stealing away the paparazzi.
That's funny.
Michael was a fun. When I heard about him having a cardiac arrest, I thought it was a joke. But then when I heard he passed away, especially with the age of 50, I mean, because I saw him a month ago. I've been training him.
I love you so much.
I worked on him stretching on the floor, all different moves, and he was energetic. He was happy as he can be. He was animated. As far as eating, he ate the same because 15 years ago, he told me he liked to only eat once a day. And I think he said he was a vegetarian. I know everybody says, how does the Incredible Hulk train Michael Jackson? We met over 15 years ago. He was a big fan of mine. He loved the Hulk and everything. So I had a doctor friend who was a friend of his. He suggested that Michael have Lou train you because I have a facility, very private, and he felt that I was the best. So when Michael came to see me the first time, it kind of like, he had the mask on, came down the driveway, and then just gave me a hug. It wasn't nothing like anything staged. It was just like Lou and Mike would just hit it up because both of us had similar childhood, and we had strong, domineering fathers. And both of us had a lot of pain and anger. And we shared that because his escape was music. My escape was bodybuilding fitness because I had such a passion for fitness. So that's how we collaborated because we became almost like kids all over again. We never had a childhood. I really never had a childhood, like social life. My childhood was introverted, and Michael was like constantly singing, his dad pushing, driving him. So he was always kind of like a kid, you know, getting whacked around. So basically, he didn't want to be like his father. Neither did I. He loved all people. He may be eccentric on the outside, but if you're alone with him, he's not eccentric because he's a prisoner. He could not come to see me for me to train him. I had to go to his house because they constantly followed him. Because every time you go to his house now, there's always people out on the street, paparazzi. There's tour bus going up down on the microphone. This is where Michael Jackson lived. I mean, we're talking about complete prisoner.
To find out if Michael was fit enough to do the 50 concerts, I sought out Michael's longtime personal trainer, the Incredible Hulk, Lou Ferrigno.
Hey, good morning.
Hey, Mr. Farino. Thank
you. How are you?
Very good.
How's it going?
Now, could you run me through a bit of the exercises you were running Michael through for the This Is It tour?
Yeah, you want to take your sweatshirt off and loosen them?
I was surprised to hear that the training was a fairly casual process, full of the playful banter Michael loved to share with all his friends.
Well, Michael came here. At times, he would have a mask on, glasses, the black hat, gloves. And I said, why are you wearing a mask? He said, I want people staring at me. I said, Michael, 10 o'clock at night, there's nobody here. Please take the mask off. So he would just look around and just take the mask off. Then he started playing with my lights. He said he wanted to darken here. I said, no, Michael, I don't want to be darkened here. So he was always, your pranks were always teasing me.
How many times did you work him out for the This Is It tour?
2 or 3 times a week for about a couple months.
And was he making progress?
Yeah.
And how was he without a shirt? Was he toned?
Yeah, all white.
All white?
White. White like you.
Are you serious?
White. Completely white.
What, his torso was right? His whole body was white?
Yeah.
How's that possible?
I have no idea.
So far, seeing who's in better shape, me or Michael. Be honest.
You. Jackson wanted to be light as he can be because of his dancing. He didn't want to put on weight. He was a fanatic about it. So that's why when he came here, we got on the scale to make sure he weighed the same. But I said to Michael, nah, how much you weigh, it's not the scale, it's how you look in the mirror. He's always had trouble sleeping, and it really bothered him. So he would just stay up late and then wake up maybe like 11, 12 o'clock. When I started with him, he would come here 10 o'clock at night to midnight. I think he needed more time to train, because after I trained him, then he would go on Burbank to work with the choreography, the directing, and the tour. I mean, it was a huge task.
Continuing our evening of magic, the Royal Luxor is proud to present The Illusionist.